Hey everyone, my name's Andy, my channel is Finding Value. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe, click the thumbs up button if you like this content. Today we're going to look at looking ahead. So what that means is we've got a vaccine, they're distributing this vaccine everywhere. So what is the ramifications of this vaccine? If people aren't worried about COVID anymore, what's going to happen? So I'm looking ahead, I'm gonna position for what I think is going to happen very soon, and we're gonna talk about what I think is going to happen. So this one is looking ahead. So what to expect? You know, we've got a vaccine. When this vaccine makes its way around and it is successful, what should we expect? We could see people really charge back to, quote, living like we were before. I think that we could see an explosion in airline demand coming back in a tidal wave type of scenario. People are going to want to, they're going to want to travel, they're going to want to get out, and they're going to do it now. There's going to be a massive demand for oil products. We can see this in China and India already. Once we get this, I think, the vaccine and it's deployed everywhere, I think people are going to go crazy and they're going to start traveling much more so than what they are today. So how does this affect our investments? What should we be looking at? So here's my opinion on it. I think that we are going to see a lot higher rates of inflation. We're seeing inflation already, and when things open up, we're going to see an acceleration of that inflation. Commodity prices will most likely lift off at a faster pace than what they are today. And in my opinion, I think we could see oil go up a lot in price, not just a little bit, but a lot. And in the background, a lot of the articles I've been reading, we've got a lot of reduced spending on the supply side because of green energy. We're gonna see a massive reduction in investment from investors. I'm seeing that with a lot of the articles. And what I think is going to happen is the supply is drastically going to be reduced. And it could be reduced very quickly because COVID and the shutdown of all this stuff and the demand destruction really dropped the supply side. And I don't think that supply is going to come back very easily. So it's setting up a situation here where oil could go up a lot. I mean a lot. So that's my opinion there. I think we're gonna get, you know, obviously Biden's gonna get into office and I think he's gonna have easy money. I think he's gonna try to push for more taxes, and more taxes are going to drive prices higher of everything. And you have to keep in mind, consumers pay taxes. Companies don't. They pass that to the customer, to whoever consumes their products. They're paying the taxes. So if you want higher taxes, you're just taxing yourself. That's all you're doing. The companies don't pay it. They're still gonna raise their prices and say, you're gonna pay the taxes, not us. We're still gonna make some sort of profit. Now, I think it's possible that oil takes off over $100 a barrel, and it could do it quite rapidly. And I don't think people are thinking about that, because what just happened was supply got reduced quite a bit. And they're cutting back. They're cutting back spending. They're cutting back investments. The oil companies, that is. And the investors are doing that to the oil companies as well. And what could happen is you could see a major spike in oil very quickly. If all these consumers and people run back, the electric vehicles aren't in people's stalls. I don't know many people who own them. So if we all start traveling, all of that is going to be demand for oil. And if China and India and their demand is already at or above previous COVID demand levels, and USA comes back with a whole bunch of demand because we've been pent up sitting in our homes so much, and people working from homes who want to get out, who want to travel, who want to take vacations, I think this is a really big setup for the price of oil. Now, if oil takes off, there's a couple of things I want you guys to be aware of. the input costs, if we have inflation and taxes go up and oil goes up, the input costs for mining companies are going to increase. Royalty companies will be protected because they don't have that risk of the input costs going up. They don't care. It's just, I get a certain percent of whatever gets produced and whatever the price of that product is. So I think royalty companies are a very good bet here. I think we're going to get one big last pull for the mining companies that are going to absolutely crush it here. It's going to happen in the beginning to middle of 2021. I think silver and gold are going to increase quite rapidly. Then those input costs in middle of 2021, everybody gets vaccinated. I think the oil price is really going to take off. I think natural gas is going to get I think it's going to catch a bid here too worldwide as production comes online, as the economy comes back, and as people start traveling. I think natural gas will also follow the price of gasoline and oil and all this other stuff, and inflation too. It's going to be a tailwind for all of our investments. So how to prepare here? I think physical metals are the spot to be. And why do I think that? Inflation will drive the cost of the mining companies higher. Boom. It's also going to push the price of the metals higher itself. Taxes are going to push their costs higher. So everything that I know of right here is going to push prices higher, and you're going to have the demand for green energy. So I can't think of a scenario where prices of all of these things are going to drop. I just don't see, I don't see it out there right now. I think all of their input costs are going to go higher, which means the prices are going to go up drastically. And the easiest way with the least amount of risk to play this is the physical metals. Then stepping back one level behind that, if you want leverage and low risk, I think the royalty companies are a perfect spot to park some money because they have leverage to the price without the costs aspect. They skip out on the input costs. They just say, what's the price of what you're selling? I get a percentage of that, irrespective of input costs. So I see this as a absolute perfect opportunity for royalty companies, because if your inflation and input costs get driven higher and they have more taxes, more everything, that's just going to push the price of all this stuff to the upside. Royalty companies capture all the upside with none of the downside. The mining companies are going to have the downside of higher input costs. So they might not make much more money than what they are today, even if the prices go up twofold. But the royalty companies, they get it all. They get all the benefits and none of the drawbacks. And I also think we've got some explorers that I like that will hopefully find more of what we need, adding value to shareholders, whether that be uranium, whether that be precious metals. And now really what you're looking at is you're looking at my portfolio and the way that I'm positioned. It's physical precious metals, it's royalty companies, and then I have a lot of explorers. And a lot of people ask me, how come I don't have a lot of producers? And this is what my reasoning is. That's why I don't have a lot of producers, because their input costs are going to go higher, and what they're selling is going to go higher, but their margins may not expand very quickly. Not anything near a royalty company. Their margins are going to go way higher if gold or silver or whatever their royalty is against doubles, and their input costs, they don't have that input cost. They just get all the profits. It's a smart business model. So that's basically my portfolio right there, is physical precious metals, royalty companies, and then explorers, which will hopefully become producers eventually. So conclusion here. I think now is the last best time to buy physical precious metals. Silver and platinum are still my favorite based off of the ratios. They are extremely cheap in relationship to gold, to palladium, to stocks. They're extremely cheap in relationship to the money supply. They are flat out cheap. And the demand for them is exponentially increasing in the future because of green energy. Royalty companies are still cheap and are showing very good promise. I like them a lot. They have all of the upside with none of the drawbacks. They are lower risk. I like them a lot. Mining companies, after this next run-up, which I think is going to happen very soon in the gold and silver run-up, and they've also run up quite a bit in the base metals, but they might see some headwinds in terms of rising input costs. I think that's going to be coming in, middle to late of 2021. You're going to see a drastic increase in their input costs because of inflation, because of oil, because of natural gas, because of whatever input costs they have. If they're buying stuff for their big trucks that they use to move things, higher costs. Everything's going to be higher costs. So oil and natural gas are excellent opportunities to capture what is coming in front of us, in my opinion. What I think is going to happen here is inflation's going to come. It's going to push all our investments from behind with a huge tailwind. We've got real estate going up very rapidly. This is all going to be inflationary. It's going to push behind our commodities, and the prices are all going to go higher. The way to play it is you don't want to be in mining companies that have their input costs all going up at the same rate that the metals are. Granted, the metals is more of an expensive price, so if it goes up 20% and their input costs go up 20%, their margins do increase a little bit. But it's not going to be nearly as much as a royalty company. A royalty company is all the upside with none of the drawbacks. It's like, why would I not go into that? Plus, they're way more efficient in terms of revenue per employee. So they're not just way higher margins, they just dip out on all the inflation garbage on the input cost side. So royalty companies, I'm heavily invested in. I like those a lot. They did exceptionally well during the last boom. I think they're gonna do exceptionally well during this boom. So a lot of people have heard me before, the commodity itself, and even Kyle Bass, I was listening to something about Kyle Bass, he's like, the best way to do it is just to hold the commodity itself. I was like, bingo. This dude who's made hundreds of millions or billions of dollars is thinking the same way that I am, which is great to hear that. So these are, I think, the best plays coming up into 2021, because you've got your physical, which is protected on all aspects. You've got the royalty companies, which is leverage without the risk. And then you've got the oil and nat gas, which is gonna be a huge push behind them, because demand's gonna come back in a freaking tidal wave. In my opinion, for those products. And think of, people flying, driving, flying, all this transportation, it's all coming back when this vaccine gets distributed. So these are obviously my opinion. This is not financial advice by any means. This is strictly my opinion and my viewpoint to get you guys to think differently about your portfolios. Thanks for listening. Click the thumbs up button, subscribe, and this is Finding Value.